My name is Sandeep Yayathi, and I'm a robotics engineer at NASA Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas.
This is Robonaut 2. He's a very friendly robot to work around. Robonaut 2 is a humanoid robot that we developed to assist astronauts in space on various different types of tasks. And eventually, we'd like to see this robot going EVA, which is outside in space. Perhaps if we're exploring another surface, like the moon or Mars or an asteroid, you could send a robot like Robonaut out ahead of an astronaut to maybe kind of assess the situation or go into an area that may be sort of questionable for safety and too dangerous for a crew member. He's both able to have the dexterity of a human, but also has a lot of strength. Robonaut 2 has the arm span of Yao Ming and biceps of Arnold Schwarzenegger in his prime. But the difference is Schwarzenegger can't hold this weight out at full arm's length indefinitely. So we studied the human anatomy and the hands and used that as a jumping point for designing this robotic system. That was one of the biggest challenges in this robot.
So the robot likes to show off his guns from time to time.
About the same as a human being.
There's all kinds of science fiction movies and things that, you know, all of us grew up watching and kind of inspired us. And the idea was to make this robot able to use the same types of tools and interfaces that were designed already for the astronaut crew members to use aboard the space station and with the space shuttle program. The natural thing to do was to gravitate towards a human type design.
So this is actually a Robonaut 2 forearm without all the shells and the skins on it, so you can see all the actuators and the hands moving.
We actually use tendons, what we call tendons, similar to human tendons, in order to allow it to move like a human hand. And because it doesn't have skin and nerves like we do, we develop their sensors so that the robot can actually sort of feel what it's grabbing onto. The robot's vision system is cameras in its head to kind of replicate, you know, your eyes. We're trying to sort of mimic a little bit of human biology, but with, you know, electronics. His brain's actually in his chest. That's where the computer is that does most of the computation. There are a lot of different tasks like inside the space station that may seem very simple and mundane, but the International Space Station is kind of like a home. Like, you have to do maintenance on it, you have to clean filters, and these are things that the robot could be doing without the crew around eventually, and allowing them to focus on, you know, complicated science experiments to benefit research going on the ground. I guess as a kid, you know, you always think about NASA exploring space, it being, you know, so up there and so far out that maybe it's not really a reachable goal. Kind of like you might think, I could never be like a Hollywood movie star sort of thing. And all of a sudden it just kind of switch flipped that, you know, NASA's like maybe working at another company or anywhere else except for the fact that it's got all these awesome goals. Best part of my job is that we get to see the entire design process. So I go from being at a desk doing design work on a computer to assembling things on a workbench right behind me and then testing those things, making sure they work. Going from being a kid fooling around with stuff at home all the way to now, you know, working here, and this is my job. It's pretty incredible. I mean, I would have never really thought that I would end up here, but it's just a matter of learning the right skills and following your dreams.